In the previous video, we walked you through the basics of LTX 2. We covered its fundamental features, but we also noted some issues, such as its relatively slow speed and the fact that the aesthetic quality of the generated characters isn't exactly top tier. In this video, we are going to share three main updates with you. First, we'll talk about model acceleration. Second, we'll cover automatic prompt generation. And third, we'll do a typical analysis of the pros and cons of videos generated by this model. I have built the workflow on Running Hub, so you can access the platform directly. In the ComfyUI space, Running Hub is a fantastic online workbench because they follow up immediately whenever new models or extensions appear. You can register for Running Hub using the invitation link in my video description to get 1,000 free credits. Plus, you get an extra 100 credits gifted every day you log in, so you can easily test your own workflows. First, let's look at acceleration. There was a post on Twitter today that caught a lot of attention. The official ComfyUI account mentioned two types of models, MVFP 4 and MVFP 8. With NVIDIA's optimization, these models can reportedly increase speed by over 3 times and reduce VRAM usage by 60%. The post itself didn't have too many details, but NVIDIA has a dedicated guide on using MVFP 4 and MVFP 8. In that guide, they explicitly state that you can indeed get a 3x S-speed boost and a 60% memory optimization. However, there is a catch. To achieve these specific standards, you generally need to be on the 50 series graphics cards. You will still see significant improvements on 40 series cards, but it might not reach the full benchmark they claim. The ComfyUI team also mentioned that these special format models are already available for download. If you look at the list, you'll see an FP4 version and an FP8 version. Note that the FP8 version listed there is just the traditional FP8, but the FP4 version is indeed the new MVFP4. We confirm this by checking the model card, which clearly labels it as MVFP4. So, how good is the acceleration really? Let's test it out. Notice that I have an image-to-video workflow open. I'll upload an image and swap the loaded model to the MVFP 4 version. I won't change any other part of the workflow. Now, let's run it. You can feel that we entered the sampling stage very quickly, and there we have the final result. Look at the time it took, about 178 seconds. This speed is actually very fast considering we are generating at 1280p resolution. Regarding VRAM usage, let's set up some basic monitoring. I'll run a command on the server side to monitor the graphics card status every second pay. Attention here, currently our VRAM usage is hovering around 17 gigabytes. Now, let's run the workflow again. It has entered the sampling phase. Look at the monitor, it is peaking at around 19 gigabytes. If you recall from the last video or have done your own testing, running the full LTX 2 model on a 24 gigabytes card is basically impossible. It just won't run. But you'll notice that with this MVFP 4 model, the overall memory footprint is significantly lower, making it completely runnable on a 24 gigabytes card. Another great feature is that even after using this quantized model, there isn't a noticeable drop in quality. Next, let's talk about prompt generation. When we get a new model, we often wonder how to write prompts to get the best results. LTX 2 actually has an official prompt writing guide, which I recommend checking out. To make things easier for you, I've created a prompt engineering setup. As usual, I am providing 2 versions, one in English and one in Chinese. The method is the same old trick we'll use Gemini. Once you start a new chat, configure the model to the most powerful one, Gemini 1.5 Pro, then paste my prompt engineering instructions into the system instructions. Now you can simply input a video topic and it will generate the corresponding detailed prompt for you. For example, I'll type "a girl cutting potatoes in the kitchen." It generates the prompt immediately. Don't be rigid with this tool. You aren't limited to just typing text. You can even upload an image and let it generate a prompt based on that. Let's run that. Okay, it generated a prompt. Now let's test it using the text-to-video workflow. Okay, generation complete. Let's see the result.
That's it. I'm thinking like, during that took a start to performing again.
This prompt generator is very effective and can help you quickly create the prompts you need. Now, let's analyze the specific pros and cons of LTX 2. First, Notice that the aesthetic beauty of the generated characters is indeed not very high. Look at the girl we just generated. She has very realistic features, which means she doesn't look beautified or particularly pretty in the traditional AI sense. However, LTX2 has a very important feature that is easily overlooked. It is a multilingual model. For instance, in the prompt, I wrote, "A beautiful Chinese girl," and she says, "Dasha hao," hello everyone. Note that this is a Chinese phrase. Let's listen.
大家好.
Notice that the pronunciation is very clear and accurate. Personally, I prefer applying this model in the image to video field. I've done a lot of tests for this. First, let's look at some common scenes. Here is a reference image of a beauty playing the piano by candlelight. I used the prompt generator to create the text, ran it, and here is the result. The overall feeling is fantastic, whether it is the character's expression, the camera movement, or the general atmosphere. I think it is excellent. Next to here is a beauty sitting in a cafe watching the rain. However, when I generated the reference video, notice there is a problem. The rain seems to be falling from the light fixture position. Let's look at the final video result. The same logic error occurred. Raindrops are falling from the light bulb onto the table. This is obviously not physically correct. Now back to the cutting potatoes scene we generated earlier. I think this scene is a classic example of what this model does best. Why? Let's watch. Notice that the girl's potato cutting action is perfectly matched with the sound effects. This example perfectly illustrates LTX's generation capabilities. Let's look at a different reference image, a water drop falling from a flower petal onto a lake surface. Let's see the result. Listen closely. There is a crisp sound when the water drop hits the lake. In these examples, the generation quality is very high. However, when displaying audio, there is often some electronic noise or static. This might be due to the low precision of the model itself. You have to be careful because the audio generation isn't always satisfactory. Sometimes serious issues arise. Let's look at this scene, a night market. There are many people and various stalls, so the background sound should be a mix of noise. If we let LTX generate this, let's listen. In this video, we can indeed hear the bustling crowd, but the white noise per aesthetic is incredibly loud. This isn't an isolated case. Let's look at this one. A first-person view of a race car driver. Listen to the result. The engine sound is there, and even the friction between the tires and the road is audible. But again, that background static is extremely loud. One last example, a scenic shot with two giant stone statues, a waterfall in the back, and a small boat. It is a beautiful scene. For the audio, we expect the sound of falling water or wind. But if we generate it, listen to the result. The white noise is, once again, very loud. So, my advice is, when using the LTX2 model to generate video, try to choose scenes with very clear, distinct audio cues and defined actions, rather than complex ambient environments. That covers a lot of content for this video, but I think it is crucial for understanding the LTX2 model properly. Go ahead and try it out for yourself. That is all for today. Follow me to become someone who truly understands AI.